Center stage, Saturday at noon, 1 p.m. Atlantic, 1:30 in Newfoundland, on CBC Radio 2.
After 57 hours of work, Tina has gone into a deep sleep. Struggled to make the most out of the distorted mission, but with the robot stuck in a shadow, it did not work for as long as planned, but it has collected a lot of new data from the comets, including drilling into the surface. Mark McLaughlin is with the European Space Agency. Probably don't seem to have that clip, but scientists do hope that the comet gets closer to the sun later this year. The light will wake up the lake, and then they will try again to collect more samples from this ancient solar artifact. The world leaders are in Australia this weekend for the annual G20 summit. While the focus is on the global economy, the group is also discussing the Ebola outbreak in West Africa. The leaders issued a statement saying that they would mobilize resources to combat the outbreak, but it did not make any specific commitments, and it stopped short of agreeing to a global pandemic fund. Helen Sophie is the chief executive of Oxfam Australia.
There's an urgent need for a response from all of the G20 countries to contain the Ebola virus. That means medical services on the ground, it means the ability to open up beds, only 22% of beds can be utilized at the moment, it means safe burials.
The Ebola outbreak has killed more than 5,000 people in West Africa. A major milestone in human health, poliovirus type 3 has been eradicated. Mass vaccination programs have stopped the spread of this once prevalent and deadly virus. There are three broad strains of polio. Type 2 was declared eliminated 15 years ago. Type 1 poliovirus is still endemic in Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Nigeria. Chris Marr is with the World Health Organization.
Of course, we still have one poliovirus, type 1, which is really aggressive and quite a serious threat to eradicate. So we're a long way from doing all of this yet. But I think that getting rid of type 3 really does rekindle everyone's optimism and everyone's feeling that yes, we can do this and we can finally finish the day off.
Polio is a highly infectious disease that can cause paralysis and even death in young children. The 16-year-old Manitoba girl who was beaten and left for dead a week ago is now out of hospital. Renelle Harper was sexually assaulted and left by the banks of the Assiniboine River. She will be staying in Winnipeg while she recovers. Her family is from Garden Hill First Nation, about 500 kilometers northeast of the provincial capital. Two male suspects, aged 20 and 17, face charges of attempted murder and sexual assault. About 3 weeks after the deadly attack on Parliament Hill, the body of the shooter, Michael Ziafibo, is still being examined by the Ottawa Coroner's Office. Meanwhile, Ottawa's Muslim community has been wrestling with what to do with his body after the pathologists finished their work, the CBC's Eddie Dyer reports.
A major cemetery said it appears vandalism, or even that the body might be disinterred. Some board members of the American Association also... One told CBC it was more disgust at his actions and fear of being associated with him, but both are factors. But in the end, the imam of the Ottawa Mosque, standing at Bali, decided that his congregation will give him a funeral if requested.
While mountains was killed as a crime, a terrorist attack against a soldier who is serving the country, he told us that if he is living on earth, if you are Muslim, then you should be buried.
The imam says that as in Christianity, even sinners are given burial rites in the belief that God will be their judge in the hereafter. But to show the mosque's disapproval of the Haftigo's actions in this life, the imam will not give the customary prayer. Adam Dyer, CBC News.